sorry you had to go through that. It's just part of Carrington life.
Oh, lovely. You know, I could use a tea to settle my nerves a bit.
There's the little stalker. It's over, Amanda. You're out of here. You can stand down, Adam. I've got everything I need.
Stand down?
Do you want to talk about Judge Whitley?
Please, Fallon. I'd rather not.
Or I could tell Blake. I mean, he should know before he introduces you to the world. Or he should at least know that a judge filed a restraining order against you that got you fired.
Judge Whitley and I were in a romantic relationship.
And I'm guessing he was married. Mm.
She was, yes. We met when I was an intern 2 summers ago. When I started at Buckley Chance, she ruled on several high-profile cases that I was on. So when the affair threatened to leak, the conflict of interest could have been a disaster.
And that's when you decided to put her pet bunny in boiling water?
Judge Whitley, Florence, she called off the affair and said I was a stalker to protect the cases that we had worked on and her career. So everything was kept confidential, and I had to leave my job. It's the end.
Well, don't you think that's something you should have mentioned?
Oh, tell the most painful experience of my life to the family I just met? Sure, yeah, I could have. Right after you tell me what's going on with Liam. You know, I feel sorry for you, Fallon. When my life unraveled, I dealt with it head on before I lost everything. You're pretending like the problem doesn't exist. So good luck with that. And I don't even know what to say about you, weirdo.
I think that pretty much says it all.
You know, I had everything under control. She was gonna move back to London. Everything was all good, and then you came in and messed everything up.
You have no idea.
Now that you've procured the box, these two items should provide you with stability. The first in the envelope is a statement transferring my life savings to you. As you know, my expenditures in life were small, so it's quite a sizable sum. Not Carrington wealth, but enough to keep you comfortable. The other is a manuscript of sorts, except it's not fiction. It is, in fact, the Carrington family's secrets that I swore to take to my grave. But I'm handing them on to you. Insurance and protection, with which you may do whatever you choose. But I hope that these two bequests will help you accomplish whatever it is you want from life. Good luck, Kirby. I love you.
Holy...